Hey guys, Nate McGill, Gwinnett Magazine. Today we've taken the Love Gwinnett Jeep to Lilburn, Georgia to visit the Tipsy Pig to get us some fall time barbecue. We actually got here in the early hours of the morning while it was still dark to fire up the smokers with some ribs and chicken. Man, we got brisket on and the best butts in town have been smoking all night. We're getting ready to pull them off. Hey, let's fire it up. There's nothing like a fall time early morning. The smell of that barbecue. Woo! Yeah, buddy.
The smoke rises before the sun at the Tipsy Pig in Lilburn, Georgia. Jacob Lee, general manager, must rise too to feed the smoker its breakfast.
We prefer to use fresh hickory.
Jacob's father, Terry, started the fires 10 years ago now as a way to make some extra income, and their take on barbecue has since become a local favorite. Jacob got an early start.
So you started cooking with your dad when you were how old?
I mean, I've been cooking in the kitchen with him since as long as I can remember. Dad, he's always had the dream of opening his own barbecue restaurant.
And why barbecue? Why did he want to do barbecue?
So he's from Tennessee.
Okay.
And,
Tennessee barbecue.
Yeah, and it's a staple, you know, where he's from.
Great barbecue is often handed down from generation to generation. I mean, the words barbecue and family can mean the same thing in some regions. But I was curious about the meaning behind the name the Tipsy Pig, though.
You know, rumor has it there's an orchard close to where my dad was raised, and there was apples that would fall on the ground, and the farmers would have pigs that would go around and eat the apples. Well, after the apples would sit there in the sun and ferment,
yeah,
they would get, you know, a little tipsy after eating the fermented apples. So,
Jacob's father has been perfecting his barbecue long before he went into the business for himself. I talked with Jacob about this fusion of regional barbecue styles as we prepped the chicken for the pit, and we talked about the Tennessee tradition, the Memphis barbecue influence, the Georgia sweet heat, all the way down to the bone-in Boston butts and the St. Louis ribs.
Some of these recipes are my great-grandmother's.
Oh.
She went by Big Mama.
Oh, really?
And, she was from Tennessee.
As general manager, now it's Jacob Lee's responsibility to make sure the Tipsy Pig lives up to its reputation. I think I lost 4 pounds chasing him around from pit to pit as he raced against the sunrise to get ready for his customers. After smoking all night, the Boston butts used for pulled pork plates and sandwiches were ready to come off. Jacob had to immediately wrap them up before I could get to them.
You can't spend time in the pit without a little bit of taste. That's breakfast as God intended it right there.
Then comes the prize jewel of barbecue, a pitmaster's pride, the brisket. A single bite can tell you if a barbecue joint deserves to exist. The Tipsy Pig did not disappoint.
This might be the best brisket I've ever had. Now, I am a little biased because I got to participate in pulling it off the smoker, but.
Perks of the job. The taste test, something I could get used to. With the talent of a Renaissance painter, the half chickens and ribs would be brushed with flavor. The Brunswick stew ready to go. The sides all prepared. Homemade baked beans, potato salad, and mac and cheese mixed up and ready to go. Because by 11 a.m., people were buying barbecue.
That's good.
Oh, and we can't forget Big Mama's famous cobblers for dessert. This day just keeps getting better. But we save the best for last.
This is the infamous pulled pork sandwich.
Boom.
It's made with 1/3 of a pound of freshly pulled pork from a bone-in Boston butt.
It's very balanced. When you get the smoked flavor, but it's so tender, you really enjoy it. Holy cow, I don't even know if I can get this in my mouth. Well, I don't know if a day can get much better than that. I want to thank all the folks at the Tipsy Pig for having me out, cook some barbecue with them, teach me all about their small business. And hey guys, look, it's Best of Gwinnett season. It's time to vote for Best of Gwinnett. So go to bestofgwinnett.com and vote for your favorite small business. It's that season. It's 2020. They need your votes more than ever. Thanks so much for hanging out with us today, guys. And until next time, I'm Nate McGill, Gwinnett Magazine.